Amory High. I'm gonna make sure we're transmitting well here. All right, there we are, everybody. Welcome to Amory High tonight, February 21st. Amory Warriors hosting Sentinel semifinal here. And we have our neighbors to the north, Rice Lake Warriors. You're breaking up, Darren. Breaking up. Well, so Darren and Julie are up in the box. Darren's having some mic problems. So the Amory Warriors have introduced themselves, everybody. We have starting lineup, Frederick Henningsgaard, Caden Meyer, Jacob Maxson, and defenders Danny Tiley and William Jensen. All right. We had to play the national anthem, which is too bad. We did have an Emory student here ready to sing, and the mic was not working, so we're having some mic difficulties. But anyway, we welcome the Rice Lake Warriors to Emory today. And I've been waiting to say this joke all day, but one thing's for certain tonight is the Warriors are going to win. Which side, we shall see. Rice Lake comes to us with a 7-win, 17-loss season. They came through the first sectional playoff at 10-0 against Medford, won handily. Emory comes into this game with a 20-4-loss record, beating Spooner in the first sectional playoff 12-0. So both these teams experienced shutout wins against their opponents in the first sectional playoff. We are now in our second semifinal. Whoever wins this will go on to play here Friday against who we can only assume may be New Richmond. New Richmond is playing Hayward. I should check that score. Oh, scoreboard. All right. So, I got a scoreboard problem here. My sidekick, Tracy Hendrickson, told me. I'm going to try and get this going here. All right. Forgive the scoreboard, but we'll keep you posted until I can fix it. Ooh, wheels. That was dangerous for Emory. Rice Lake is definitely on the offensive here. Ooh. All right, I got to fix the scoreboard here, but guys, it's 0-0. Obviously, 16-20, first period. We're just 40 seconds into the period. Vinny Green has the puck. Tough angle shot. I'm trying to reboot my camera here. All right, let's go. Share this camera. All right, I'm going to wait. All right. Comes out of the zone. Stuart Helly underneath. Drops it in. Goes around the back. Rice Lake goaltender Matthew Nesser stops the puck. Rice Lake flips it ahead. Cruz Juhas. All right, I'm trying to connect this scoreboard camera. I do have an update on Hayward, New Richmond, too. New Richmond. Let's see here. Sorry, I'm gonna. Okay, deep in chain 192. Alright, we got the camera. Now I gotta do some fancy footwork. Forgive me for a second. Alright, here we go. We're getting there now, people. Sorry about that. There we go. How's that? There we go, everybody. Ooh, a big hit right below us here. Rice Lake's getting physical right in front of their own bench. So Danny Tiley flips it in, backhands it there. All right, New Richmond versus Hayward. Just a score update. 5-2, New Richmond, 14 minutes. left. Danny Tiley shoots. Caden Meyer tries to deflect it in the net. Does not go. William Jensen over to Jacob Maxson. Flipped up and out of play. All right, so 5-2 New Richmond. All right, we got the scoreboard up. I am surprised that my lack of technology allowed me to fix it, but with the help of Tracy Hendrickson on my text messaging, we got it. Thanks, Tracy. Let me know how the sound is. We've been playing around with the sound. Hopefully it's good. Behind Amory's net. Of course, Amory's senior, Clayton senior, Avery Starzecki in the net, senior captain Avery. In the net for Amory. Puck up and out of play, so stops, the whistle stops play. All right, who do we got here? We got Dylan Ike. Hey, Dylan. Got Donna Stein, that's Blue. Blue Anderson's Canadian Nana. Great fan. Beth Grasser, Cruz Juhasa's auntie. Also a great fan over the seasons. Eileen Marquis, yep. Eileen is a longtime Amory resident. Worked for the paper forever. Ramona Lockwood, teacher here in Amory. Thanks for watching, Ramona. Sally Pickard, longtime Amory resident. All right, here we go. Oops, Stewart tried to drop. Oh, that was dangerous, Stewie. Luckily, that was offsides. Stewart tried to drop pass it, and it either hit Stewart's skate or Cruz's skate. Sat there. Momentum didn't allow Stewart to get back. Cruz did a flyby, and Rice Lake picked it up. So dangerous here. We got a... The one thing that makes me nervous about the Amory hockey squad is if they're down, they get kind of desperate, as in any, I suppose, any situation when you're down, right? So it's always... I always have a lot more confidence when we're the first to score, but that does not mean the first to score is always the one that has the most points, so we'll see how this goes. Puck comes out of the zone, Amory into neutral. Rice Lake flops it right back in. Takes an awkward bounce towards Starzecki, but he has his eye on it. Does his goalie magic, blocks it out. Blue Anderson in the corner looking for a pass. Kellen Marsh there, number 10 for Rice Lake. I know Kellen because I know his mom and dad, Aaron and Amy. And I'll try to, I know a lot of Rice Lake folks are watching because the roads are kind of bad. So I'm going to try and be a pretty neutral announcer here, as any announcer should be. But we'll see what happens here. Danny Tiley keeps it in. I don't know a lot of the Rice Lake players by number, so I'm going to have to cheat a little bit. So there might be some pauses, but we'll try to get some shouts for Rice Lake actions here too, so we know what's going on. Danny Tiley takes it deep into the corner, gets a little, ooh, nice try there by Caden Meyer, wide left of the net. Up and out of play. So a couple pucks flipped up and out of play, both sides trying to get their traction here in this first few minutes, first 5 minutes almost is done of the first period of the semifinal game on the postseason trip to state. As I said, one of these teams is going to win, and one of these teams is going to play here on Friday. And again, assuming from the score I've heard, will be against New Richmond. New Richmond's a tough team, a lot of good skaters. But as you all know, on any given night, any team can beat any other team. And at this stage in the season, coaches are not injecting new plays or anything magical. They're just trying to keep their kids' heads screwed on straight, keep them healthy, keep them not injured. And they should be just mostly building on what they've already learned through the year. All right, dump gets past Cruzios for an icing call. So Starzecki, goalie, gives the ref the puck. Gentleman and scholar, that Avery Starzecki. And I like to see those players help the refs when they can. The refs have a tough job. They are not overpaid, and a lot of times the only time they hear anything from anybody is when people are mad at them. So A shout out for our refs. Nice quick shot there by William Jensen. Nice shot. Max Mike over there against the boards looking for an outlet pass. Right onto the stick of a Rice Lake player. Looks like he has some speed, but we got William Jensen going back. Gets body in the way. Good job, William. Looks like the puck's underneath, and the refs call the play dead so they can gather everybody. So we got Pam Humple. Pam's a longtime Warrior mom, Warrior grandma. Longtime supporter, Coach Humple's mom. So Pam's watching. Love you, Pammy. Thanks for watching. Abby Novinska is another coach's wife. Abby's good enough to give us her husband, Cody, for all the time it takes that he's been sharing with our kids. So thank you, Abby. You guys got kids of your own, so we appreciate that. I know that's very unselfish. Nice. Here we go. Danny Tiley does not keep it in. Here we go. Max Mike got some room. Sorry about the camera work there. Stuart Helly in the corner. Stuart calls me last night at 4 o'clock or texts me and says, hey, I need a new stick. I'm like, oh. If you guys know, Stuart bought his own stick about 5 weeks ago. And it was $280. He came home and he's like, hey, I got a deal. The guy knocked off, you know, like $30. So I only had to pay $250 for it. And I'm like, oh, my goodness. Luckily, those sticks have a warranty because Stuart broke it. He has a 30-day warranty. Stuart broke it about 27 days into its life, and he got another stick. And then what happened is it cracked last night. Now, luckily, it's still strong enough to play with, but we just have some good backup sticks ready to go in case he breaks it. So, you know, I've been waiting to buy a really nice musky rod, feeling guilty about spending family money on a $200 St. Croix musky rod, but sounds like I might have just got a green light to buy a really nice musky rod if we're paying $250 for sticks. But anyway, another story. I digress. So 9:35 left in the first period, 0-0, 5-3. Amory's getting some fresh legs in there. It looks like Caden Myers taking the face off for Amory against Rice Lake's Jake Coons. And again, they're scrapping here. Nice deflection there by, nice stick by Jacob Maxson. Here we go, there's Freddie Henningsgaard. Gets body. Kellen Marsh tries to hit it up for Rice Lake. Little nice. That is an awesome opportunity. Jacob Maxson, again, he's a freshman, number 14, Jacob Maxson. He's got a rocket. You know, for a kid that's young, doesn't even have his license quite yet, he is physically very mature, and mentally he knows the game well. So it's going to be really fun to watch Jacob Maxson mature even more as his high school career develops over the next, you know, he has 3 more years of high school hockey. He's a freshman this year. So, again, fun to watch Jacob. Danny Tiley. Blast it back. Stuart Helly behind the net. Lots of pressure back there. Let's see what can happen. Danny Tiley. Stuart behind the net. Of course, now all I want to say is, Stuart, don't break your stick. Don't break your stick. Oh! Tries to backhand it in there. Got partner. Walk it in, Danny. Nice move. Oh, that was a soft hit. I don't know who that hit. I think it hit a Rice Lake player. But when you don't hear it hit something hard, that means it did not hit a pad. It hit soft tissue, muscle, or flesh. So whoever got that might be a little bruised tomorrow. Here we got 27, Taylor Garapy up against that Jake Coons, number 15 from Rice Lake. Faceoff. Danny Tiley keeps it in, flips it up into the corner. Taylor Garapy tries to backhand it out to Mikey Kelly. There you go. Mike Kelly keeps it in. Good job, Amory. Nobody's over there, though. It's in a sea of blue. Let's see what we can do here. Yep. Kellen Marsh gets it out for Rice Lake. Amory shoots it toward the net. Goaltender's forced to block it away. Nice pressure there by Garapi. He's a scrapper. Amanda Fisk says I can buy the muskie rod. She's married to an outdoorsman and has a bunch of kids that are outdoorsmen, so outdoors people, I should say. And good. Amanda, I'm going to tell Jen you gave me the green light. I might have to come stay at your house if I, me and my new muskie rod, but yeah, why not? All right, Jacob Maxson takes it into the zone. Nice speed by Jacob. Look at Freddie right in the sweet spot. Freddie goes, takes his spot behind the net. Caden Meyer now in front of the net. Let's see if we can set something up here. Freddie's controlling it out to point. Jace McManning over to partner, has a lot of room. Hits. So you could probably hear that hit. That was a nice pad block, and you can tell. I'm sensing the momentum for Amory picking up here a little bit, but we really got to take advantage of it. All right, I'm right above the Rice Lake bench. It's always a fun spot to be. Coach Josh Engel, he's been around for quite a while, has a nice little hockey pedigree himself. This Rice Lake team won state last year, Division II, so they've been to the big dance, they've been to the big barn and succeeded. Now their team has changed a lot since last year, lost a couple players. You know, they graduated some seniors, and then some of their players were so advanced they went elsewhere to play. Really kind of leaving this team in a rebuilding year. And, you know, last year they were, again, every team is different every year, right? Amory's going to graduate. Here we go. Let's see what happens. Vinny Green. Nice. Vinny draws first blood. That was an awesome. Is that passed by Stewie? It looked like it was. So Amory draws first blood. I want to say Vinny was just cherry picking there. Nine from 22. Vincent Green from Danny Tiley. So, Amory draws first blood. 6:26 left. Darren's having, oh, nice save by Starzecki. Sorry about that. Camera was off, but I was helping Darren here. He announced that goal for Vinny, and of course, we're having some kind of an issue here with the microphone. All right, let me back it up here. We got Donna Starzecki. They're all watching from St. Paul. Some of my favorite fans. Avery's grandpa, grandma, brother. Amanda Fisk, of course, who gave me permission to buy a muskie rod. I like that, Amanda. Freddie Henning's going to centers. Oh, good job by that goaltender. Rice Lake gets it out, and it's going to go down for icing, I think. Nope. They're not going to call icing. It just barely trickled in. All right. Jacob Maxson flips it into the zone. He's going to go get his own flip. Jacob's getting physical. He's an assertive player and a smart player. So there we go. William Jensen flips it in. Riley Zemers cheering for Amory and Betty Jo Warner. I like it. I got to give a shout out to my coworker, Shia Swanson. Shia was watching from home. I think she's watching. And her daughter, Landry. Hi, Landry. I hope you're watching. I know it's your bedtime here pretty soon, but, you know. Shia said you'd be watching, so I have to give you a shout-out, Landry. Maybe we can talk Shia into signing you up for hockey. We'll see how that goes. All right. 4:52 left in the first period. 1-0 Amory. So far, a really fun game to watch. A little back and forth. Like I said, I sensed the momentum moving Amory's way right before Vinny scored there. And Vinny over to partner Cruz Juhas. Cruz into the... Oh! Hey! Matt Mike scores. So, was that... Who shot that? Was that Vinny that shot it? No, Cruz shot it. Bounced out. Stewart got it. And then Max. So I think that's going to be 13-11. 11-5-13. There we go. Well, I think 5 scored that, but. All right. Jackson Henningsgaard in the house. Jackson, the mighty duck from Oregon. Is it Oregon or Oregon? It's Oregon. Yeah, so Freddie's older brother, Jackson's playing hockey. Playing hockey out in Oregon for the Ducks. Cut out. All right, shot on Amory's goal. I was giving Darren some... Darren's throwing up the paper. He's giving it up. All right, Mikey Kelly taking it into the zone. Let's see what happens here. Nice centering pass. Taylor Garapi was tied up. Shot right on goal by Taylor. Nobody's going in. We're doing a little bit of a line change. Okay, William, when you got that much room, my man, you got to skate up. You don't have to give that questionable pass up. You guys got ice, use it, right? If they only had earphones and I could tell them how easy it looks like from up here, when in fact I know how hard it actually is. All right, Jacob Maxson getting in the battle. Caden Meyer, again, I love watching Caden skate. Caden is a scrambler. Not always pretty, but man, he gets the job done. You know, there's fluid skaters like Frederick Hainsgaard. You know, Blue Anderson, I would call like a fluid skater. Just pretty to watch, right? And then you got these chuggers. They're just chugging away. Just looks like every, you know, step is just, they're giving it their all. And that's Caden Meyer. And what I love about Caden, they could be up 10-0, 20 seconds left in the game, and Caden is still playing like it's a tied game, you know? Some kids are almost too smart for themselves and are like, oh, you know, I don't have to play that hard. All right. So number 19... for Rice Lake. Owen Storberg, freshman forward, is in the box. Amory finds themselves on a power play. Rice Lake on a penalty kill. Got Rice Lake's Jake Coons again centering this. Obviously, Jake must be... Yep. Stewart, hell yeah. I don't know what's going on there, buddy. Get it together. Stewart just made a bad pass, and then he just didn't collect the pass. So let's take a deep breath, deep breath. Nice pass to Vinny. Vinny, you used a 9-iron. You should have used about a 6-iron there over the net. Vinny Green up on the point. Stewart. Stewart's tripping on his skates. I don't know what's going on. Nice two-shot volley on Rice Lake, and Amory's going to get a penalty. Cruz Juhas. And Cruz is using his best defense lawyer skills. Let's see what they called there. Goalie interference? 13 white interference. Gives a little wind in the sail of Rice Lake here. I can hear their bench explode. Go from a... 5-on-4 situation to a 4-on-4 situation. I don't know what's going on with Stewie's skates. Hopefully. Whether he needs to tie him tighter or sharpen him or what. But almost the end of the first period, so that's helpful. If they do have to tweak some things, they got time. Caden Meyer in. Nice move, Caden. Caden's a little upset. All right. Danny Tiley. Cross pass. William Jensen through neutral into the zone. Shot gloved by Matthew Neisser, Rice Lake goaltender. Junior goaltender, Matthew Neisser, number 31. All right, minute 9 left in this first period. Amory leads 2-0, 13 shots to 4. Rice Lake bench is pretty active, pretty fired up right now, so. Oh, what's the score of the New Richmond game? Let's see if I have it here. Six to two with 8 minutes left. William Jensen across the boards. Nice job, Max. Mike to Vinny Green. Oh, nice screen there by the Vinny. Shot it right between a Rice Lake player. Beautiful screen onto the stick of William Jensen in the backfield there. I'm making up terms. I don't know if backfield is a hockey term, but it sure made sense to me just there. Puck around the Rice Lake goal. 28 seconds left in this first period. Here we go, Vinny Green. Oh, trying to pick it off again. Amory's staying back, defending the neutral ice. We got some cherry pickers here on the red line. And there's Kellen Marsh, passes over to Jake Coons. Jake is going up through the zone with speed. Nice shot toward net by Jake Coons. Nice block by Amory defender Danny Tiley. Oh, Jake Coons looked like he was going to slam that one home. Shot, boy, and caught by Starzecki. All right, passions are high in front of the Amory net, right? One period down, 2-0. High-intensity game, fun game to watch. I'm going to play a little... play a little video for y'all.
Metro, don't trust you. Caporetto.
All right, back for the second period. I'm sure Coach Engel and the Rice Lake boys had a good talk between periods about how to turn the score around. Amory, I'm sure, had things to work on as well. Kevin Smith and the ice crew did a wonderful job giving the boys a nice, fresh, shiny sheet of ice between periods. Caden Meyer against that Jake Coons taking the faceoff. Rice Lake wins it back. Number 25, Nathan Carroll. All right, Jake Coons is on a mission right away. Shot up and over Starzecki's goal. Behind Amory's net, big Jacek Manning. Tries to backhand it, does get out of the zone, so nice steal there by Freddie Hinningsgaard. Flips it ahead, still has it. Freddie, good job. Somebody help him, somebody help him. Oh, and Freddie gets launched. But that's why we love this game, right? Physical, mental, and emotional. Right, that Jake Coons obviously he's a playmaker for that Rice Lake squad. I've been saying his name a lot. That number three for Rice Lake, junior Remy Wager. He's another one I think you'll see in some plays. Nice, so Rice Lake comes out hot. They come out hot in the first minute of the second period. All right, we're going to have a face-off. Here we go. All right, you're going to be icing. So let me tell you what happened with Hayward and New Richmond. New Richmond Tigers versus the Hayward Hurricanes. Down in New Richmond. New Richmond had home ice advantage. New Richmond did win 8-4. 8-4. So New Richmond will be here Friday for the sectional final. The winner of this game is going to be who New Richmond will play. Now, nice quick shot there by Kellen Marsh, number 10. Nice block by Starzecki goaltender. Obviously, that New Richmond game was earlier. So I assume all those New Richmond folks are maybe watching. So howdy, New Richmond. Can't wait to host you up in Amory. Nice shot by Vinny Green. Nice block by Rice Lake's goaltender. Again, shots almost double. Amory 15, Rice Lake 8. A lot of game left. Max Mike gets the puck shot right in the liver there from Vinny Green, but Max is still up. William Jensen over to partner. Quick shot, nice block there by, oh, puck's still alive. Stuart Helly flips it behind the net. All right, flipped out. Is it going to be icing or no? Oh. Well, William gets burned on the blue line there. That's okay, though. Danny Tyler will go back and collect it. Let's see if we can set something up. Blind pass up to William Jensen. Come on, guys. Do not lose the puck in our zone. That is silliness. Blue Anderson collects it back in our zone. Over to partner Danny Tyler. Danny's looking for an outlet pass up to William Jensen. Goes past him for an icing. All right, guys. Amory has to tighten up their passing a little bit by the looks of that last volley. Again, easy for me to say. The fat bald guy sitting up here, but Rice Lake. Now I'm saying New Richmond, but game's far from over, and Rice Lake has some skills. So we gotta put a little bit more room between us and them on that scoreboard before we can get too excited. Taylor Garpy gets a little helmet to helmet hit there. Worried about Taylor because he did have a concussion earlier this year. Looks like he's going strong. Looks like he's got his legs underneath him going to the bench. So, Taylor, I hope you're okay. Caden Meyer in the corner looking for help. Blue Anderson helping him back there. Got Freddie. Freddie's waiting for something to come out. Nice. Freddie shoots left of the net. Back to Cruz-Juhas. Shoots. kicked, block kicked there by, or foot kicked by Rice Lake's player. Rice Lake hits it up high on the ice. Jacek Manning can't get it. Goes back to the goal line to Starzecki. Back to Jacek Manning. Dangerous pass by Jacek, which gets intercepted. Jacek Manning up to, there we go. Frederick Haynesgaard in the zone. Jacob Maxson going in. Looks for a pass and blocked by one of Rice Lake's players. William Jensen in neutral. There we go. Oh, come on, guys. Don't trip on each other. There we go. Jacob Maxson. Up and out of play by... Or nope. Oh, it stayed in. Sorry about that. I thought it was up and out of play. 12:58 left in the first. Jacob Maxson had such a nice opportunity there. And nice. Nice shot, William. Just a little bit wider than that. We need a line change. These boys are getting pooped out. Is that going to be icing? Okay. So a nice shift there by Amory. Jacob Maxson had just a beautiful shot. Actually between his legs and had the stick, I think, behind him. He tried to hit it between his legs, but just an awkward shot. Couldn't get it in there. All right, we got the aunties here. We got Jaden Link. 8-4, New Richmond beat Hayward. Silvana and Beth, that's Cruz Yuhas's aunties. Hey, Dr. Edling's watching. Dr. Edling, I don't know you, but heard good things about you. I know some of my friends use your healing powers, so way to go, Dr. Edling. Thanks for keeping people healthy out there. All right, 12:21 left in the second period. Not quite halfway through the game. 17 shots to 8. Now Amory has gone past twice the shots, barely, of Rice Lake. 2-0 score. Stuart Helly over in the corner. Well, Max Mike lost that puck in traffic. Onto the stick of that number 3. Remy Wager. I named him before. Remy Wager and this Jake Coons are a couple kids I think you got to watch. I'm going to say Kellen Marsh is another one. He's an experienced player. Went to state last year. Let's see how these other guys are. Remy Wager's a junior, so he went to state last year. Jake Coons is a sophomore, so he would have been a freshman last year. Probably went. So, yeah, so nice season players on Rice Lake's lines as well. Here we got Rice Lake's number 18, Tacoma Rendelhoft. I might have butchered that, Tacoma. And actually, it's not Tacoma, it's 16, Dayton Shackey from Rice Lake. I told you I would try to give some shouts to the Rice Lake boys as well, but I do not recognize them as well as I do the Amory kids, so sorry about that, I'm butchering the names. 11:29 left in this first period. Nice job, Cruz Yuhas, keeping it in. Your aunties love it when you do that. Keep that puck in the zone. Nice job, Mikey. Mikey Kelly gets that. Oh. We're going to get a call on that. I don't know if you saw that. I don't know if that's going to be Jacek or if that's going to be number 20. Well, that was 24. 24 from the Warriors versus 24 from the Warriors. How's that? All right, it's going to be a Jacek. All right, penalty called off. Jacob Maxson up on the line here. Nice pass, but Jacob had to turn around to collect it, and so it kind of stops your momentum when that happens. Nice job, Cruz. Oh, Cruz keeps it in the zone. Here we go, Kraus Yuhas. Good job. Here we go. We got a little runaway train. Nice pass by... Oh, good job. Sorry about the camera work, guys. Darn it. Anyway, but Rice Lake had a nice little runaway. 2-on-1. They did a great job, an unselfish pass there. I think it was number 19 for Rice Lake. Owen Stoiberg, very unselfish pass to a guy in the center. And Frederick Haynesgaard coming off the ice after that last hit. Looking more annoyed than injured, but it was kind of an awkward hit. So 22 from Rice Lake is Parker Dirks, freshman forward going in the box, and we're going to have Amory power play on the right end of the world even. It's on the Rice Lake end. Vinny Green. All right. Megan Gilbertson, Rice Lake fan. Yes. We'll give you a shout out, Megan. We like the Warriors, blue and red. How's that? And we love the sport of hockey, so we appreciate you guys sending your team down here to give us a run here. And yes, you're absolutely right. I mean, I'm an Amory Warrior fan. I'm an Amory Warrior dad. I live in this community. But you know what? I love watching good hockey. And if Rice Lake can come back to win this, all the props to him, I tell you. So, Megan, welcome to the watch. Thanks for chiming in. Hopefully my broadcast is serving you well in spite of... Oh, Jacek Manning was going to pass it over to the ref. Ref doesn't have a stick, so he didn't collect it. But yeah, hopefully, I know the roads are bad, so maybe a lot of you are watching tonight, and I appreciate that, and I hope you're liking what you see here so far. Of course, if you're a Rice Lake fan, you don't like that score being a big goose egg. Lots of game left, though, and lots of skill on that Rice Lake team, so we'll see what happens. All right, Jacek Manning passes up to Blue Anderson. Nice block there by that 25, Nathan Carroll. Got his stick on it. All right, we got a melee over there. All right, Blue Anderson. Blue Anderson, number 16 trip. So, Blue, take a break. Plenty of game left. We need your legs fresh anyway. Nana Stein saying Canadian well wishes for you. And come out hard. All right, Amory on a penalty kill here. Rice Lake has the puck in Amory's zone, which is always dangerous. Let's see if William Jensen can clear it. Over to Frederick Henningsgaard in the corner. Danny Tiley. Why not, Danny? Can't score a shorty unless you're short. Offsides, Caden Marr. Caden was already in the zone, I think, and got a little offside, so. Jace Fitzgerald. There we go. So Jace. Jace is giving a shout out to Kunze. Kunze, Jake Kunze, number 15. He's at the faceoff dot there. And obviously Jace Fitzgerald showing him some respect. Let's go, Kunze. All right. And the crowd goes mild. So we got Vinny Green, number 9, against Kunze. I'm going to call him now that Jace gave me his special nickname. Kunze and Vinny together forever at the faceoff dot. Vinny wins it. Comes up ice to Vinny again. Back into the corner for Kellen Marsh. Aaron's son, Kellen Marsh. Underneath me here, Rice Lake clearly has their strong line out right now. There we go. Strong stick wins here, boys. Let's see. Nice control by Vinny Green. I love that. So just going to take it behind the net. Let's control it. Kill some time. And he launches it. Nice chip. Rice Lake takes control. Gets up to Kellen Marsh in neutral. Gets a nice little nudge by Max Mike there. Nice centering pass. Nice shot on goal. Great goaltending there by Matthew Neisser. Kellen Marsh again trying to get an outlet pass. Just a little bit too far in front of Kunze. And here we go. Vinny Green. Shot towards the net. Got 30 seconds left in this penalty kill for Amory. Power play for Rice Lake. All right. Nice pass up to Kunze. Bringing it in the zone. Shot and blocked by Starzecki's shoulder. Wow. Wow. Couple of shots. They're running out of power play here. 4 seconds left. Good job. Nice stick. Caden Meyer, nice. Go Blue. He's resting up. Had his little penalty. Nice, Blue. That would have been sweet if Blue came right out of the sin bin and scored. But Blue, you had 2 minutes to take a break, and that's just what we needed to get a little wind in your sail. I like it. Freddie Hainsgard into the zone. Freddie looks for pass here. Get control of that bugger. Got a bit of a breakaway from number 11. Nice stick by Kruzihaus. Tripped. They're not going to call that a trip, huh? Well, I guess he was going for the puck. I would have called that a trip, but nonetheless, they're going to let him play. Frederick Hainsgard on the far boards with the puck, going forward through neutral, looking for an outlet pass. Blue Anderson going off ice. Jacob Maxson coming on. Jacob's going to go quick to the puck in the corner. Jacob flips it ahead behind the net. You got Caden Meyer giving chase. Floppers on the ice. It's crazy down there. Puck's coming up to Danny Tiley right underneath me, and Danny gets hammered into the... it wasn't that strong of a hammer. It was more of a surgical bump into his bench area. Bubbles? Jace, who the heck is Bubbles? Or no, that's Cole Fenske. Bubbles? I don't know who Bubbles would be. I don't see a name in Rice Lake that would match Bubbles. Come on, Cole, you got to give me some names here. But it's good to see that those Rice Lake boys are watching, Jason, Cole Fenske. Rice Lake alums are used to play there. Oh, let's go, William. Stuart Helly flips it up into the corner. Let's see what happens here. Nice stick. Get back, William. Kunze had a perfect opportunity there. Starzecki sure got in his way there. But Kunze used the sand wedge instead of the three iron there and shot it up over the net. So pretty frustrated coming back to the bench. All right, Jace Fitzgerald, number 8 is Bubbles. Let's see who that is. Carson Tomash. Okay, that's a name I recognize from back in the day. Again, a lot of these guys, all these guys played coming up. My son Stewart on the Amory team played with some of these guys in the summer. And, kind of fun. So we are competitors tonight, but we also all love the sport of hockey. And... in small town Wisconsin, we gotta give each other support because hockey, unfortunately, is kind of a constricting sport. It's not growing like gangbusters, so we gotta hold on to dear. We gotta hold dear to what we have. Do our best to introduce young kids to the sport and keep our rinks and our reputations as clean as we can. How's that sound? And Rice Lake has a good hockey history, definitely. All right. Well, into neutral. Back to Jacek Manning in the corner. Jacek goes behind the net. Over to Mikey Kelly. Mikey's got some awkward stick moves there. And they score. There you go. That was a dangerous move by Amory by not controlling the puck, not getting it out of the zone. And a 2-1 game with 3:37 left in the second. Shots on goal are catching up. Now Rice Lake's 12, Amory's 18. So Amory, you better bat in the hatches. Thank you. So Jace Fitzgerald, you and your cheering for Kunze helped him score there. All right, Rice Lake is getting a little wind in their sail. They're getting excited. So Amory's got to answer here quick and strong. Borgestad. All right, we got Pat Borgestad in the house. Now it's going south. Borgie coached a lot of these boys back in the day in Blaze, and we hate to say we do kind of love Borgie a little bit. I got a little bit of a man crush on him, mostly because he has such nice hair, but no, he was a good coach to a lot of these kids in Blaze, and again, I don't want to get Borgie's head too big, but Borgie, a lot of these kids developed under Borgie's tutelage, so we appreciate you, Borgie. All right. Hey, even Stewart, look at that. Let's see if he can get that puck back. Or he's just going to trip Kellen Marsh and call it a day. There's that Kunze. Jake Kunze. He's the one to watch. Dangerous, guys. Dangerous. All right. Rice Lake is riding the wave here, and the wave is going to come in hard and fast if Amory doesn't crash it. All right, we got some Rice Lakers hooting away at that goal. Borgie's trying to pick a fight. I'm just going to ignore you, Borgie. All right, Jacob Maxson around the horn. Mikey Kelly can't collect it. Goes into neutral. And back to Cruz Ujas. Let's go, Amory. This is how they scored last time, that exact side. Let's go. Get that bugger out of the zone. All right. Well, that'll do. Got Cruz Ujas. Biggest little guy we know on our team. That was a terrible pass, though. Cruz, I don't know what you're thinking. Pass it right back to... We can't afford to do that right now. You got to collect yourselves, Amory. You can hear below me the Rice Lake bench is fueling up. Their power meter's going up. And, of course, I'm not above the Amory bench, but. All right. I think Coach Engel here said it well. He goes, Rice Lake, you got the momentum. Now hold it, hold it. And I think he's absolutely right. They do have the momentum right now. So Amory's got to pick something up here. Oh, boy, that's dangerous. Jacob Maxson going in for tripping. Okay, we're in a dangerous position here if you're an Amory Warrior fan. Oh, my gosh. Now Jace and Pat Borgestad are making... They're hitting on each other over my comment page. I think this is not Swindler or whatever that thing is, swipe right, whatever that thing is. So no space for a man crush over here, Jace and Borgie. You guys do that on your own time. Dangerous situation here for Amory. They need to get in the locker room and quell this. Long seconds left in this period. Luckily, Starzecki stopped it. So, Amory, you want to get out of this period right now. And what would even be nicer is if you could go down and score, because... Tell you what, if they go into the locker room with this this momentum, they're going to come out with this momentum. So let's go, boys. Dangerous. Very, very dangerous position for Amory Warriors here. Come on, Amory. You got to get this out of the zone here, guys. And get. There we go. Go, Freddy. Go, Freddy. Freddy, get your stick down. Drives me nuts when kids have their sticks way up in the air and the puck's on the ice right underneath them. Vinny Green set something up. Dump and chase, zero. All right, so we're coming out of a dangerous period here. If you're an Amory Warrior fan, we're coming out of a kind of an exciting period if you're a Rice Lake Warrior fan. Rice Lake came out after the first, kind of quiet. Amory started making some kind of some lazy mistakes with passing and puck control, and Rice Lake took advantage of it, right? So we find ourselves in a 2-1 game. Far too close for comfort. If you're an Amory fan, and nice and close for comfort if you're a Rice Lake fan. So good job on that period, Rice Lake. Both coaches are going to take their teams into the locker rooms and give them the old Herb Brooks speeches. And I'm going to go upstairs and put the herd on some Mariko's nacho cheese dip and some of my wife's famous Swedish meatballs. So we're going to be back in about 11 minutes. Kevin Smith and the ice crew is going to put a nice glossy sheen on the sheet. And we'll be back in 10 minutes. You guys go get your refreshments and snacks, and we'll be back for an exciting third period of Warrior versus Warrior hockey here at the Amory Ice Gardens. All right. Welcome back, everybody. What do we got here? Any new comments? Is Pat Borgestad and Jace done hitting on each other? All right. Welcome back. Third period about to start. Emory Warriors versus Rice Lake Warriors. Said it before, but I'll say it again. One thing's for certain, the Warriors will win tonight. It's a terrible joke, but practice it all day. Here come your Emory Warriors. Hopefully Henningsgaard gave him the Herb Brooks speech. Hopefully Stewart sharpened his skates. Yeah, I was joking. I was like, hey, Jen, at least Stewart didn't break a stick. She's like, where have you been? He broke a stick the first period. I was like, oh, shoot. So anyway. Rice Lake's coming out hot. Ready to rumble. Again, just to recap, New Richmond beat Hayward 8-4, so New Richmond will be here on Friday for the sectional final. Whoever wins this game, which is by all means not settled with this 2-1 score, whoever wins this game is going to be playing against New Richmond on Friday. Whoever wins Friday's game is going on to state. So we got Vinny Green facing off with Carson Tomash. Bubbles, I think they call him back. I think they call him Bubbles, if I read my comments correctly. Again, thanks to Kevin Smith and the ice crew. Nice looking sheet of ice. 16:45 left in this game. And it's going to see. We're going to see what happens here. Ooh, nice try there by Freddie Henningsgaard and, or, I'm sorry, Vinny Green and William Jensen. There we go. Vinny Green shoots. Easy block by Rice Lake. Up and out of play. Whistle stops play. Had a 2-1, but he must not have seen what he wanted to and his partner there to pass it over. So. Thanks for watching tonight, you guys. A lot of Rice Lake fans watching. I like that, I guess. Welcome to the show. We like Rice Lake. I mean, we don't want you to win, necessarily. But, you know, if you're the better team, you're going to win. How's that sound? Boy, there's like a melee right here in front of the Rice Lake bench. Jacob Maxson drop passes it. Cruz Juhas picks it up. Looking for an outlet pass. Nice. Freddie Henningsgaard was a flyby here. Come on, Freddie. Jacob Maxson takes it in the zone. Got help. Terrible camera work. Who paid this cameraman? All right, there we go. Now Rice Lake is doing what Amory was doing last period. Little backhands in their own zone. Putting it on our stick. Rice Lake's number 19, Owen Storberg, takes the puck up. We got Jake Coons in the corner against Cruz Juhas. Cruz punches it out into neutral to Kellen Marsh, number 10, on the far side. Swings it back here to Max Tomash, number 7. Got a couple of Tomashes, Max and Carson. One's a freshman, one's a senior, so that's kind of fun. I assume they're brothers. Probably some friendly rivalry there. Ooh, nice physicality there. Boy, Taylor Garpy, 27 behind the net. He's working. There we go. Now Rice Lake's doing what we were doing, except we don't want to just get rid of that puck. Oh, I love the tenacity of Taylor Garpy back there in a sea of blue, just scrapping for that puck. Out onto the stick of Blue Anderson. Back to partner. William Jensen, quick shot. Ooh, deflected up by Mike Kelly, but wide of the net. Let's see here. A little too much time here by Mikey Kelly. Race Lake gets her number on it. Hey, kept in the zone. Good work, Billy B. Shoots. Nice block by goaltender Matthew Kneeser. Ooh, Parker Church taking me out of the Eagles nest up here. Holy cow. I haven't even sworn yet, and they're trying to hit me with pucks up here. All right. 14-16 left in the third period, 2-1. Shots on goal are 20-17. Shots on goal are, the gap is closing, which tells me Rice Lake is picking up its game. Amory needs to capitalize on something here, and soon. If Rice Lake scores this tying goal, I think we're going to have... We're going to have an energy bubble. It's going to be hard to overcome. Vinny Green, nice try to center it. Oh. Stewart. Pretty close, but they got a whistle. They got to blow it every once in a while so they know it works. Having some chamomile tea tonight in my coffee cup. Hopefully that centers me a little bit. What do we got here? We got Megan Gilbertson, Rice Lake, yep. Come on, Amory, Auntie Beth, Brian Actor, easy boy, give her hell good luck, yeah. Brian Actor's my buddy up in Hayward. And, okay, what do we got here? That's not the kid you want to have a puck backhanded toward the net. Starzecki blocks it easily. Vinny Green? Oh, come on, guys. Backhand. Nice thought. I knew what Vinny was trying there, but. Skate now. Chip from Stuart Helly up to Vinny Green. Vinny in the zone. Max Mike. And of course they're going to put two guys on Vinny. Quick shot by Kraus Juhas. Loose puck. Oh. Vinny Green's just going to get physical. I'm just going to shoulder that kid. Well, here we go. 3-2. Nobody there. Momentum is shifting, but Amory has to make this happen. Oh, we're going to get a penalty. That's going to hurt. God darn it. William Jensen did not get back quick enough. His partner gets a tripping call. Okay, it's William that got the tripping. I thought Max Mike got it. So, Amory, this is not... we have a one-goal cushion. And... is what it is. Jeez, we got a bunch of. Debbie Meyer, thank you, Debbie. Rooting on Amory. Dylan Ike. Diane Mike, that's Grandma Loopy. That's Max Mike's grandma. There you go, Caden Meyer. Here's what I'm talking about. Chug, 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 chug. Work, 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 work. Work, 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 work. Oh. All right. Nathan Carroll's going in the box. But that was a perfect example. That last rush down the ice, Caden Meyer, that was my perfect example of what sums up Caden's character and athleticism. Not very fluid, not very pretty, but man, he gets it done. So, Caden, proud of you. Grandma Loopy, that's Diane Mike, that's Max Mike's grandma. Wow, got to be the best announcer of all time. Somebody... has been dipping into the Jack Daniels tonight. But hey, I appreciate the shout out. I do my best. You know, I ran into Anthony LaPanta at the Wild game and I invited him to come and help me, but frankly, he said he was a little intimidated, but maybe sometime. We'll see how it goes. All right. Let's see if we can get something going here. Freddie Henningsgaard set something up. Up here to Caden Meyer. Caden's looking for something. Still loose! Okay, guys, you got to keep playing. Here's that Jake Coons with the puck. You don't want him moving up ice unattended. All right, we got some 4-on-4 hockey. A lot of ice going on here. A lot of ice, a lot of space. This should be a good game for our Vinny Green. Give him some space. There we go. Get up there and help him now. Oh, Vinny. Darn it. Comes out of the zone. We're going to have to regroup in the neutral. Look for passes, Vinny. Can't do it all by yourself, brother. Nice pass by Cruz Juhas. Blue Anderson. Gets a little chop there like an oak tree. Boy, those backhands are killing us, you guys. Unaimed backhands. But I know they're necessary. But I wish I could ban them in all of hockey. All right. Puck comes out to Cruz Juhas in the neutral. Back around the horn. 10:27 left in this sectional semifinal game. Max Mike's going to beat it over. Nope, Cruz Juhas is going to beat it. He's going to beat his player, too. Centering. Vinny Green over. Nobody in the middle. Nobody in the middle. Let's set it up, guys. Don't. Here we go. Oh, nice shot by Jacek Manning. Stuart Helly knocked over. All right, nice hustle back, Jacek Manning. Good job. All right. Great attempt by Rice Lake. Great. Great attempt by Rice Lake rushing the net. That's about the fastest I've seen Jacek Manning get back on D. So Jacek, nice hustle. Very close game. Very exciting game. But the winner here has to be smart. No more penalties here. You cannot give the other team a one-man advantage. It's getting down to the wire here. Puck up and out of play. And it's going to be an icing. All right, faceoff's going to be way down on Amory's end again. A little bit dangerous. 2-1, 25 shots to 21, as you can see on the scoreboard in the upper right. Danny Tyler collects the puck. Stewart. All right, let's see if we can, oh boy, dangerous, Sir William. We got to be stronger and smarter with our passes. There you go, Danny. There you go, Stewart. Good job breaking that off of Kellen Marsh's stick. On to Stewart's. Oop, back in the zone. Center. Come on, Amory. Let's fire it up here a little bit. That shouldn't end up on the stick of a Rice Lake player after it went through two of you guys, so let's go. Jennifer Swenson in the house. Thank you for the compliment. Thanks for listening. Vinny Green gets sandwiched against the boards. Vinny's used to being a little piece of baloney, though. He's tough. He's good. Stuart Helly gives a little bit of pressure, but doesn't get close enough to really cause any damage. Puck behind Starzecki. Back to Taylor Garapy. And does not sense the Rice Lake player right on his heels. Very dangerous. Very dangerous. Through traffic. Luckily, it just went wide and behind. Stewart, I don't know what kind of a swing that was, but you know what? I got a pile of oak that you can split until you can have a better aim with that stick. How's that sound? All right, puck all the way around the corner, and an icing call. Whew. All right, I haven't been doing a lot of food reviews today. I did have a piece of pizza early on, 3-meat Orv's pizza. You know, and they cut it. A piece of pizza here at the Amory Ice Garden is it's a quarter of a pizza. You get 4 pieces out of a whole pizza. It's a pretty healthy piece. $2, full meal deal. Got nothing bad to say about it. Cooked to perfection, served with a smile, and anything with the word meat in it is my friend. 3-meat pizza by Orv's at the Amory concession stand. I'm going to give it a 9.5 tonight. Kirsten, my coworker, said I got to start reviewing food a little more. Well, there you go, Kirsten. Mikey Kelly collecting the pass, getting it in to Blue Anderson, over to Taylor Garapie. Taylor, quick shot in. Again, too many sand wedges out of the bag here. We got to start pulling out the five irons, guys. Of course, those of you who know hockey, you know that these sticks are curved and they are angled. So, you know, everybody wants to shoot it high into the corner of the net and everything else. I think back in the day, you know, wood sticks were just straight, but they're pretty scientific now. But a lot of these boys, for some reason, end up shooting over the net, which tells me maybe the curve should not be the curve and the angle should not be as high as it is on some of these sticks. I don't know. Now we get it out of the zone anyway, forcing Rice Lake to regroup. Okay, now we're just working hard to get the puck out into neutral and give it away. I don't like it. Puck up and out of play by Blue Anderson. Caught by a nimble Rice Lake mom. I wish I could zoom in. Those Rice Lake moms are like spider monkey ninjas. Fast and furious. Good work. Of course, you got to be tough to be a hockey mom. But good job, Rice Lake mom, in the stands. Way to protect yourself. Way to catch that puck. Jacob Maxson against the boards. I don't know what that was. He just gave the puck to Rice Lake. William Jensen going behind the net. There, it's collected by somebody. That's Danny Tiley. Cross-ice pass. Luckily, Jacob Maxson's there. Let's see if Jacob can do something with it. Shot and rebound! And a flyby. Caden Meyer just had a little too much momentum. Couldn't get back to that puck. Here we go. Puck comes out of the zone. Onto the stick of William Jensen. Dangerous deflection there, but luckily he gets picked up by Caden Meyer. Back to William Jensen. Over to Freddie Henningsgaard. Freddie over to Jacob Maxson. All right. Goaltender does a good job of stopping it. A little bit of a slow whistle there, but nonetheless. Caden Meyer takes a swing at him. Then he gives him an attaboy afterwards, saying, hey, man, I just, you know, swung at you. There's no whistle. Appreciate you, Caden, for being a good sport. And goaltender Matthew Kneeser, junior goaltender from Rice Lake. Been doing a good job today so far. Quick shot and traffic and shot up and over. Vinny Green again. Using the sand wedge instead of the five iron. Bring back the wood straight stick. It would be fun to outfit a whole team with old gear and just see how they do. They would be crabby. Kraus Juhas keeps it in. Vinny Green, and flipped out by Rice Lake. You got big Jacek Manning going back to get it. And pressured by Rice Lake's 14, Paul Sirik, senior defender Paul Sirik. Stuart Helly trying to break another stick. Oh, nice centering pass to no one, Rice Lake. Good thought, though, but nobody was there. Cruz Juhas, pound for pound, strongest Amory player we got. Vinny Green chips it up. Let's see if Vinny can get that back. Yes, he can. Hands Vinny, we call him. Nice. Get in front of the net, guys. Don't stay behind the net. Don't need to be there. Oh, what do we got there? Nothing called there, but Stewart got nailed, pushed over. You guys better hope Jen doesn't see that. She'll come out there and get you. Stewart Helly on the far side. Nice. Let's see what Stewie can do other than break sticks. And a flyby. All right. Rice Lake up into the neutral zone. Pass William Jensen's stick. Onto the stick of Taylor Garapie, onto the stick of Max Mike in neutral. And they're doing a line change, so what do we got, icing? All right, 5:10 left in this 2-1 game. Whoo, it's a barn burner, everybody. It's a one-point game, anybody's game. And nice job, Starzecki. Keep going. Mike Kelly over on the boards. Oh, that's dangerous. Right in the middle. Don't get desperate and get a penalty. All right. Taylor, that would have been a nice pass, but you shot it past Blue. And onto the stick. Here we go. Here we go, Blue Anderson. Blue. Boy. Taylor Garapi looks okay, but man, he is getting manhandled out there. That guy's getting beat up. All right. Back there to Kellen Marsh. There we go, onto the stick of Frederick Henningsgaard. About time Freddie puts one in the net, huh? That'd be fun. Caden Meyer, help him out, Freddie. Help him out. Caden keeps it, but there we go, onto the stick of Remy Wager. Jacob Maxson is going to skate out of it. Nice little saucer pass cross neutral. Good block there by Starzecki. Does not get out of the zone there. Gets out of the zone. See if we can win this here. Freddie Henningsgaard. Frederick against Kellen Marsh. Coming around the corner. Nobody home. It's going to come out into the zone onto Jacek Manning's stick. Back around the horn onto Jacob Maxson's stick. I like it. All right, Amory, we got to set something up here. Nice job, Cruz. Don't lose that, Kraus. Nice. Cruz got his feet in the way there. 3:18 left in this 2-1 game. Well, Amory, if you're not going to score, I guess at least possess the puck here. All right, down to the wire. Tomash centers, and luckily Amory gets it out of the zone. Got to kill some time here, Amory. Got to get some puck on your stick. Do not give it away like that. That's stuff we cannot do, Mr. Danny T. You got to control the puck here. It's far too close of a game to be giving them the puck in our zone. Stewart, let's do something here. Borgie's watching, Stewart. Borgie's watching. What are you going to do? Oh, nice try by Stewart there. Beautiful try. 2:12 left in this tight one. And are we not going to skate to the puck, Danny? Okay, lucky they called that icing. Boy, you got to skate, man. All right. .08 left in this 1-point game, anybody's game. Amory's got the pad, but it ain't a thick pad. It's more like one of those prison mattresses. I don't know. I guess I've never slept on a prison bed, but it sure isn't a Serta certified comfort bed. Rice Lake offsides. We're down to 1:57 left in this game. So it's going to be interesting to see what Coach Engel does here from Rice Lake. Is he going to try and get a one-man advantage, pull the goalie in a one-point game? I don't know. I mean, this could go either way here. Oh, Kraus had kind of an errant pass there. We got to stop passing down the stick of Rice Lake. There, it's behind the net. Jacek Manning goes to get it. And again, he's on his backhand, which is awkward. That's out of the zone. Thank the Lord. Kellen Marsh over to... Nathan Carroll over to Kellen Marsh. Nice pass by Kellen over to Owen Storberg. Shot on goal. Luckily, that's going to be icing all the way down again. All right, we're not going to get icing. Goaltender's going to get an assist here. Going to try anyway. A minute 11. Rice Lake's pulling the goalie. Rice Lake's pulling the goalie, and they got a skater, 22. Empty net. Yes, Amory scores the empty netter.
Yes.
Good job, Caden Meyer. All right, still got some time here, boys. Let's not start throwing the bouquet till we're married here, boys. 20 from 14 and 23. That'd be Caden Meyer, my little chugger. From 14, Jacob Maxson, and 23, William Jensen. All right, timeout, Rice Lake. Coach Engel's going to talk to his boys. I'm going to bring up these. Bracket again. So if you look at the upper left, New Richmond beat Hayward. And the winner of this game will play Hayward here in the beautiful Amory Ice Dome on Friday at 7 o'clock. Again, we are not hosting that because we may be in it. We put a bid in to WIAA to host the sectional final. It's a big moneymaker for our association. It's a source of pride to have people here. By all means, you put our rink up against some rinks in the cities. This is an older rink, shows its age, but we're still proud of it. And everything that's here is stuff that we have taken care of and kept up. This rink was built in the early 90s, so it's, 30-some years old. And, we're proud of our rink, and we're proud to have people come and play here. So, nonetheless, so we're hosting the sectional final on Friday. If Amory can control the puck for this last minute. Amory will be playing. So Frederick's using his best defensive skills there to talk to the referee that it wasn't his high stick. Got a little ref convening there. All right. So one ref saw it differently than the other, and we're going to have a center ice face-off. Got Vinny Green against Kunze. Kunze's given Remy Wager a little bit of there we go. See, Jacob Maxson, can you win it? You can win it. All right, 45 tenuous seconds left. Vinny Green onto the puck. Freddie Henningsgaard underneath the Eagles' nest here. Back to Vinny Green in the corner. William Jensen. William Jensen has it, backhands it, and onto the stick of Rice Lake. Shot through traffic. Dangerous shot. Only 13 seconds, 11 seconds, 10 seconds, 9 seconds. All right. This is going to end with a near empty netter. 2.3 seconds left. 31 shots to 25 at this stage in the game. Rice Lake. It'd be a miracle if you can score two in 2.3 seconds. But, and that miracle won't come for Rice Lake. So, we see young Kellen Marsh skating back toward his teammates, knowing that, their season has ended here in Amory. Now, props to Rice Lake, state champs last year. Props to the coaches and managers, the school and the program. We appreciate having you nearby. We appreciate having your competition. And we've always appreciated playing Rice Lake. I dare say I have some friends. Some of your parents are friends of mine, so I appreciate that. Amory Warriors, good job today. A little close for comfort, I'm not going to lie to you. You know, you scored first, you scored more. But, man, that was a close game. And Rice Lake, you know, that puck could have flopped either way there for a couple times. But, Amory, good job. We are going to the sectional final in our this ice arena, our home ice arena, which I appreciate having home ice advantage. So getting a lot of congratulations on the shout-outs. I appreciate that. Good job, good job. Thank you, guys. Appreciate you, Rice Lake viewers. I can't, you know, I wish you the best. You know, you guys had a great experience last year, and glad you kept it on this side of the state last year, and I'm hoping Amory can keep it on this side of the state this year. New Richmond, no lie, is going to be tough on Friday. Those Tigers, you know, we did beat them early in the season, 3-2, but there might have been some extenuating circumstances there. But again, any given night, anything can happen. So hats off to Rice Lake Warriors. Safe travels home on this snowy Snowmageddon night. Hats off to Coach Engel and his staff and referees. And congratulations, Coach Henningsgaard and staff, on making it to the sectional final Friday. So we will be back Friday, everybody. And game at 7, we're going to live stream it. We're going to have tickets for sale. And away we go. Gage Fox, you must be a New Richmond player, huh? I like it. Great season, Rice Lake. Better luck next year. Yep, I agree. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. I haven't gotten fired from this job, but if I keep talking, you know I'm going to say something wrong, so I better stop while I'm ahead. Congratulations, Amory Warriors. Thank you, everybody out in We Are Amory Land, for watching. Join us Friday night at 7 for Amory versus New Richmond. That'll be a fun one. Can't wait. See you then. Have a safe rest of the week.